Good day. How are you this morning? Yes, we are back again for another subject, and the subject is home economics. And the topic is parts of the body. Parts of the body. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to understand the three main parts of the body. Explain the functions of the parts of the body on the head, on the trunk, and on the limb. We have the parts of the body divided into three main parts: the head, the trunk, and the limb. So you have to know the functions of those parts of the body. Now I have here is a human picture diagram. This is a baby. By showing us the parts of the body. Can you see it? The head. We have the head, the forehead, the nose, the neck, the mouth, the elbow, the wrist, the band, the thigh, the knee, the heel. We have the stomach, the fingers, the chest, the arm, the shoulder, and the neck. This is the woman part of the body. Now, what is the human body? The human body is the entire structure. It is the entire structure of a human being. The entire structure of the human being. Now, I told you before we started that the part of the body is divided into three main parts. Into how many parts? Three main parts, and they are the head, the trunk, and the limbs. The head, the trunk, and the limbs. With the three main parts of the body is one, head, two, trunk, and three, the limbs. The limbs. These are the three main parts of the human body. Now, the head is the part of the body that contains what? What can you find in your head? We have the hair. We have the eye, we have the nose, the mouth, the ears. This is what the head contains. I said the what? The hair, the eyes, the nose, the mouth, and in the mouth we have the what? Teeth. The ear. This is what the head contains. The head contains. And then the next part is what? The trunk. The trunk contains your chest. The chest. Also the back. The trunk. It contains the chest, the back, the hip. The hip. This is the hip here before the thigh. Before the thigh is the what? Hip. And then the stomach. The stomach or the abdomen. This is what the trunk contains. I said what? The hip, the back, the chest, and also the last one is what? The abdomen. This is what the trunk contains. Now, the limb, the limbs. The limbs is used for movement. It is used for what? Movement. And number one, one of it is what? The arms, and also the legs. These are the parts of the body used for what? Movement. So the limbs is used for what? It is used for movement. And they are what? The arms and the limbs. They are the arms and the limbs. The arms and the legs, sorry. The arms and the legs used for movement. Now, I want to see the function of the body parts. The function of the body parts. Now, we have the hair. The hair. What is the hair used for? The hair keeps the body warm in cold weather. When you have hairs on your body, if the temperature changes to cold weather, you see that the hair helps to do what? Regulate the body temperature. It will help to keep the body warm during the cold weather. And also, it helps to improve personal appearance. By the time maybe you want to change your hair cut to low cut, you see that it will change your appearance. But when you start making hair or you have a full hair, you see that it will also do what? Change your personal appearance, and it will make your it will add beauty to you. It will add beauty to the person. Remember, I told you the hair does what? Protects the body from what? Cold weather. Two, it adds to the personal appearance by adding beauty. And three, it protects the head. It protects the head. When as there is hair on your head, it helps to do what? Protect it. By the time you want to, maybe you have an injury, before it will penetrate, it will do what? Prevent injury on the head. Then the next one is the eye. The eye. Remember, we're talking about the function of the what? Parts of the body, the head. Then we have the eye. The eye is used for what? Seeing. I can use my eyes to see. So it is an organ used for seeing. The next one is the nose. The nose. Nose is used for what? Smell. And also, we use it to breathe in and to breathe out. We use the nose to breathe in and to breathe out. Then we have the mouth. I'm using my mouth to do what? To speak. We use the mouth to speak and also to eat. You want to chew anything, you use your teeth. Inside the mouth, we have the word teeth. We use the mouth, the teeth to bite and to chew and to cut. Now, we want to see the function of the trunk. Remember, I told you the trunk has the what? The chest, the hip, the back, the abdomen. Now, I want to see the function of the chest. The chest, it houses the heart. You can see your heart because the chest does what? Covers it. It protects it. So, it houses the heart and the lungs. The heart and the lungs. When you see the human diagram, you can see the diagram of the heart and the lungs. So the chest does what? Protect the heart and the lungs. It protects the heart and the lungs. Then we have the abdomen. The abdomen, it contains the bowel and the digestive system. That is what we call the stomach. The stomach, you can, oh, I can touch my stomach. Inside there, when you eat, it helps to do what? Keep the food you've eaten. So that's what we call the bowel. Then the next one is the digestive system, which helps to do what? Digest your food. And by the time it has taken everything it needs, it will now take it to the excretory system, where you do what? You take out the waste from the body. So the abdomen contains the what? The bowel and the digestive system. Now, let's see the function of the limbs. The limbs. The limbs contains, I told you, it contains the what? The legs and the arms. And in the arms, you can see your what? Your hands. So what do you use your hand to do? We have the hands and the fingers. What do you use your fingers to do? It helps you to walk, to write, to do anything you want to use your hands to do. Then what do you use your legs to do? As I'm standing here, the legs gives me support. The legs gives me what? Support. So the legs gives support. It helps you to stand firmly without falling. Do you understand? That's what I mean by support. So the legs gives support.
except the person has problem with the legs, where the person say, oh, I cannot stand again, my legs are paining me, or I'm having fun that my legs are shaking, I can't stand. So you see that the legs give support, and also it helps in movement. I can use my leg to go to my house. I can use my leg to come to the school. I can use my leg to play, to run, to jog. So you see the legs helps in dancing, running, walking. Do you understand? So this is the part of the body. Remember I told you the body is the entire structure of a human. Entire structure of a human. I told you it's divided into three main parts: the head, the trunk, and then the limbs, which is the legs and the arms. And I told you the functions, which we have the hair used to protect, to keep your body warm. And I also told you it protects the head, and also it does what? It gives you a personal appearance by adding beauty. And also the trunk, which is the chest and the abdomen. I told you the chest, in it you find your what? Your heart and your lungs. The next one is the abdomen, which contains the bowel and the digestive system. Then the limbs. The limbs I told you is used for movement, which you have the arms. And the arms, you can find your hands and your fingers. You say you use it to write, you use it to draw, you use it to wash, use anything you want to use your hand to do, to eat. And then the legs, I told you, is used for support. Use it to stand for a long time because it supports you in standing. I also said it's used for walking, for running, and for dancing. So I'm going to give you a homework to do. I'd like you to write it and send to the platform. Now see your homework. Number one is enumerate the three main parts of the body. We have the three main parts of the body, list them, and you can even give us what they have. Remember I told you the head, what can you find in the head? Just enumerate, list them and tell me what they have. Then write two functions of the hair. Then the limbs. The limbs is used for what? What is it used for? Then write its functions. What are they used for? Just write the functions of the arms and also the functions of the legs. This brings us to the end of today's class, teaching and learning. I'll see you in my next class. Bye.